Hey everyone, so welcome to today's video. So in this video, today we'll be discussing about Google Gemini with video prompting. We already saw about some demos happened from the Google side. All in that demo, that some people said it's a fake, it's edited like that. Some people said it's a crazy, it's mind-blowing like that. But there is a lot of confusion about that. So in that video, we can see how is that really work actually. So in that video, we'll be deep dive into that Gemini with the video input, and don't skip that video. Let's see. All right. So coming to that video prompt part. So before that, I need to first set that API key, Google Gemini API key. So in that environment variables actually. So as you can see that in that you can see that add-ons. So in that there's a secrets is there, right? So in that API key, there is a key I can put it already. So you can get that API key from that Google Gemini site, ai.google.dev. So after that getting that Google API key, so you can add, just add in the new secret key and you can put that API key, that secret key. So I can attach that and I can just done actually. So now we need to set here some workflow actually. So the first thing, download a video from any link. Also, you can use it using some dataset folder, or if you have a local video, so that you can use it, and extract all the frames and extract the keyframes from the video based on that structural similarity, actually, so that adjustable threshold like that, right? So, and the pass the extracted keyframes as images along with instruction to prompt to Gemini Pro version model. And Gemini performs that excellently on the given that task actually. So this is the workflow we are going to take that today actually. So the first thing we need to, I'm just using that Kaggle notebook actually. So, all right. So the first thing I need to import some necessary things actually, like we have here all the console outputs, right? So that all the inputs. So I need to mark down that actually. So for that, I can just simply let me type. Yeah, here's the thing. So I can just take that first user secret clients. That means the add-ons from the secrets, we need to get the API key, right? So that is this library. And this two for that markdown thing. And the pathlib and text wrap. So for the text formatting thing. And that. So I'm getting the API key. And also I just creating a just markdown thing actually. So this is what it done. Let me execute the code. All right, executed actually. And Google Gemini APIs is freely accessible of now with limited capabilities actually. So you can get your own API key from that ai.google.dev, and also you can just copy that API key and put it in that secret key in the add-ons menu above actually. All right, so the next thing, I can use that library called PyTube. So it's being used to download here one of the YouTube video. It's a high resolution MP4 video. So using that library, you can download that YouTube videos using that Python. Link is passed to that YouTube objects that saves that video in that my Kaggle directory actually. So the first thing, I can install that PyTube. So here's the thing, pip install PyTube. All right. So let me execute that. All right, now it's installed. So the next thing I'm going to putting that code, so that same as from PyTube, import YouTube. So I have a YouTube short links. So that link I can just put into that, and after that streams.get highest resolution download. So if I run that actually, so I can just copy that link. I can put it in that. Let's see. So here is the video. So I'm going to analyze that actually. All right. All right. So the next thing, we'll be downloading that video. So now that video will be get download. All right. So now video is downloaded, and that after that, we need to import that some required libraries actually. So like pandas, numpy, opencv, all those things for the image processing, right? So that's the thing. Import pandas for the data serialization, and a numpy for the number serialization, and cv2 for the image processing, matplotlib for that graphical things, and globe and ipython for the formatting that, and tqdm and the sub process. So these are the things I can just import at that, and also as you can see that, so before that, we have a file name that how to organize notes shards.mp4, right? So that first we need to check, is that really that file is there or not? So that's we need to check. So for that, I can writing the code called file name equal to ls. So in that, so I'm getting the file name actually. So if I run that, how to organize notes shards actually. So now we have a file. So the YouTube video, if not in that MP4, can convert it to the MP4 using the subprocess module for further processing. And the file name should be set as a MP4 converted video.mp4. So I'm going to just set it that actually. And the next thing, I'm using that FFmpeg. So that FFmpeg, what it do is, it will be reading that video. And after that, it will be converting and do the scaling. And it will be converting as a MP4 file actually. So this is what I'm going to do. So in that, I'm going to type the code. So here is the code, input file equal to file name, and that getting the file name. And after that, I can put it in that input level. After that, it will be scaling it, and it will be converting as a MP4 file actually. So if it is not a MP4, it will be convert. If it is MP4, then it will be that simply pass it actually. So this is what it will be do. All right, now the process completed. So after that, we have a MP4 file. So that file we are going to play in that our notepad actually, notebook actually. So, all right. So here is the thing, ipd.video. We already converted that file, right? MP4 converted video, and also width, I can just set it out. And if I run that, now the video is playing actually.
How to organize your notes, and written notes are good for comprehension, but
so this video aborts fully with the handwritten notes. So this handwritten notes I can pass to the Google Gemini thing actually. So it's a crazy, right? Yeah. And the next thing, using OpenCV in Python to create a video capture object and read the frames from the video file named as a MP4 converted video.py. So I'm going to just simply read that video using that OpenCV. That's all. Other than that, I didn't do anything actually. So here's the thing. And if I run that, now the video object will it get create. So the next thing, we need to count that frame counts actually. So if I run that, so totally in that short video, so we have 1780 frames actually, we have actually. And the next thing, we need to get the that frame height and width actually. So that two things we need to get before we start the processing part. And so in that part, let me run. So I can just simply run that. We have a video capture object dot get cap prop frame height and a frame width. If I call that, so it will be returning that frame width and height. So 1280 and 720 as well actually. And the next thing, we need to get the frame FPS actually. So for that video, so some of the videos will it have that 60 frames per second, some of the videos will it have the 30 frames per second, right? So that same thing, so I can just getting that, confirming that how many frames per second actually. So if I run that FPS for 30 frames per second, all right, now it's simply good. And the next thing, we need to read the image of shapes actually. So let me run. So we have already have a video capture object, and in that, we are going to just read that image, and in that image, I'm going to return that just shape of images. So same as 1280 and 720 as well actually. Now plotting some of the frames to visualize the images in that notepad actually. So in that, the first thing I'm going to use that some matplotlib things actually. So we already implemented plot.subplot 3,5 figure size equal to 30,20, and that should be a flatten. And as well, we have a that CV2 capture things already, right? So in that, so now it should be get empty because we just created, but we'll not put out anything actually. So we created that video capture, and also we have a prop frame count like that actually. And so in that part, I'm going to read each frame, and I can put it in that matplotlib actually. So I have an image index. I'm reading the frames one by one. So if 1500 frames come, so at that time I'm giving the break. So I'm going to take that 100 frames actually. So each 100 frames actually. So in that, if I run that code, now the frame will be reading. All right. So now as you can see that that frame 1, frame 100, frame 200, frame 300. So each 100th frame we have actually. So up to 1400 frame actually. So now we are going to introduce one more library called SSIM. It's used for measuring the similarity between the two images. It's also kind of background subtraction. It will be comparing the two images. If it is same, then we can ignore that image. If it is different, then it should be a new image actually. So that is called SSIM. So it's a similarity between the two images using that scikit image library we are going to use, and also defining that threshold for the similarity index. And because if two images is same, so at the time sometimes will it get a 80, sometimes will it get a 40, sometimes will it get a 10 actually. So we need to find put some threshold, and based on threshold it will be extract the keyframes actually. So this is not only best way to extract the keyframes. Try using the different approach for the better performance from your side actually. And the selected frames being stored in that output directory called selected frames output directory. So I'm going to store all the things actually. And so the next thing, I'm going to start that similarity thing actually. So I have a scikit image and a matrices and a structural similarity as a SSIM and import OS, because I'm going to read the all the images from the OS directory actually. So the next thing, we need to open that video file. So this is the thing, MP4 convert video.4, and also I can just the cap from frame count. So it will be returning that count of frame. And also I'm going to create a directories. So selected frame directories. So if it is exist, it's true, or else it will be creating a directory as well actually. Under that, I'm going to creating a threshold as a 0.5, like 50% actually, obviously. Yeah. And the next thing, I'm going to do that that SSIM logic actually. So let me type the code. So here is the code. So in that, so I have a n frames and processing a frames. I'm just printing actually. So each loop it will be get printing, and we have a 1700 frames actually. So it will be running 1700, and we have a index. So in that index we have a cap object, and we'll be reading that frame one by one. And that first image will it come to this part, and after that it will, we will splitting into that BGR. And first frame is there, at the time this module will be get skipped. If second frame is comes, so at the time previous frames have a valid value actually. So at the time we have a current frame and we have a previous frame. So at the time it will be comparing with that BGR. So it will be structural similarity index for each channel. It will be comparing that. And also once it's compared that, after that it will be creating that some scores actually divided by 3, because we have a 3 images, 3 layers BGR actually. And after that we have already threshold 0.5. So the maximum threshold should be a 1.0, that means 100. And it should be a similarity index threshold if it is less than, and after that selected frames it should be appended actually. So once we get the all the selected frames, we will be uploading the all the files under that selected directory, selected frames directory, and we will put the all the files and we will be releasing that cap actually. So if I run that code, yeah, now it will be processing it. So it will be taking some time because 1780 frames is there. So it will be doing that one by one, and it will be collecting, and it will be creating a folder finally actually. So let me wait. All right. So now the processing is completed. So that means that SSI, so that part is completed. So the next things, we need to count that how many frames we filtered using that SSIM actually. So I'm just printing that total keyframes based on the threshold, choosing that selected number of frames actually. So if I run that, totally 10 images we chosen. So in that 10 images, we need to see that, right? So what are the 10 images we will sort it out actually. So I just created that code, selected frames. Under that, I can just loop that each frame. I can just put it in that plot show actually. That means in the matplotlib actually. So if I run that, so as you can see that, select frame 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 9 actually. The 10 frames will it there. And the next thing is the grayscale images are stored into the selected frames directory in that PNG format actually. So the next thing we need to just list it out. So how many files names is there inside the selected frames folder actually. So if I run that, so these are the folders there under the selected frames folder actually. So the next thing we need to directly communicate with it, Gemini API actually. So the configuring that API key based on that the Gen AI model actually. So I'm going to import that Google.generative AI and import Gen AI actually. So that import Google Generative AI as Gen AI, and in that Gen AI.configure under that API key equal to API key. So if I run that, so now API key, it is get from the add-ons and from the secret. So there you can getting that API key, and that API key will it just applied over there actually. And the next thing, converting the images into that pillow format for the passing to the model actually, because model expecting that some of the required parameters actually. So that's why we converting the all the images as a pill format. So in that I'm just importing that pill library, and I am just reading the all the images as a pill and append to that image array actually. So if I run that, now all the images should be under that pill actually. So now I'm going to just display one image, the first index of image. If I run that, as you can see that how to organize notes and modern India like that, I just put that get the hill shape folders actually. So this is a first image, and the next thing is generate text from image and a text prompts using the Gemini provisions and calling the model actually. So in that I'm going to use that Gen AI, and in that generative model I'm going to call that Gemini provision actually. So if I run that, now the model is called and passing the instruction, the next thing passing the instruction to the prompts and some saved images to the model for evaluation actually. So in that I'm going to type, so here is the thing, so instruction should be a consider the following images, prompt one, what is shown each of the images, so that answer the questions through the step, identify if any text is written in the images, identify the any doodles in the images, grasp the collective meaning of the each images, what does all the images tell us all about the personality of the person who wrote it actually. So that answer and describe that steps taken. So I can just take that four images and 0 to 4, and I just send it to that model actually. So if I run that, so you can see that it just now I send it that, and now that four images will send it to that. And I will wait for the response. It's loading. Yeah, now we get the response actually. So as you can see that, that response one, in this image, there is a mind map, how to organize the note for subject on the modern history. That mind map includes topic rise of nationalism, Indian National Congress, the British Raj and the independence movement. And the image two, image three, up to image four, in this image, so as analyze level, the four images together that show that person who write them organized and detailed oriented. They have clear understanding of the material have to taken to find the create visual representation of their notes actually. This suggests they are likely to be a successful their studies actually. So actually all the people were said, some of the people said it's a fake, some of the people said it's a crazy like that, but from my side it will be remarkable model actually, because it will be supporting both images and text based, both it will be get supporting and it will be get analyzing, and also will it return understanding that flow, it will be just simply written to that our user actually. So currently it's in free to use, so we can use it that. And this is what I want to share to you guys, and I hope you guys really like that video. And if you really like that video, please subscribe my channel for more videos like this in the future. Also, if you have any queries or comments, please leave them in the comment section below. I am happy to respond. We'll see you on the next video. Thank you. Bye. We hope you found this video informative and helpful. If you did, please hit the like button and consider to subscribe our channel for more videos like this in the future. Also, don't forget to share this video with your friends and colleagues who might find it useful. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them in the comment section below, and we'll be happy to respond. Thank you for watching. We'll see you on the next video.